Good evening. I am Mr.Hosi Daruwalla. I am 67 years old. I retired from ACC as a design engineer. And when I took voluntary in 1999, in the year 2000, I took voluntary retirement to take care of my grandson. And in the year 2000, May and June were not very good for me. I was losing weight. So I went for a checkup to Lady Ratan Tata Institute for 50 rupees. Head to toe, and within half an hour I was told that I'm a leukemia patient. Not knowing what is leukemia, I asked the doctor what is leukemia, because it was Greek to us. Then he said it is blood cancer. I said, okay, no problem. I'll go ahead with it. Let me know what to do. Then he guided me to Dr. Suresh Parikh and Mr. Agarwal. Then I went to Dr. Parikh's clinic. Then the assistant told me, you'll have to wait, you'll have to go through these tests, etc. But I said, I want to meet Dr. Parikh. He said, no, it will take time. I said, no, if I cannot talk to the doctor, then what is the sense in getting treatment? I took my file back, went to the Lady Ratan Tata Institute again, asked them. Then Dr. Preswala told me to meet Dr. Agarwal. I went and met Dr. Agarwal. And from June 18th, 2000, the ball started rolling for chronic myeloid leukemia, blood cancer. Now it is about 10 years now. I'm fighting it out. I fought it out. And how I fought, I'm trying to explain to you and tell. That number one is willpower. Solid willpower. Very, very important. If you don't have the willpower, then you cannot achieve any goals. So after going to my doctor, after going to the entire protocol of chemotherapy, I took 142 shots of chemotherapies. No, it's okay. 142 shots. There are three types of chemotherapies. One is where you have to be hospitalized. Second, which I took, muscular. Third is the oral, which I am taking today also. So I preferred the muscular because I could take care of my grandson also. So I used to take three shots a week. Each shot was about 300 mg, 300 to 400. And costing 1,500 each injection. That within 15 injections, I started bleeding. My tongue became blue. All these fingers became blue. I started losing my hair, etc. I lost hair right from top to bottom. And I was bleeding from my nose, bleeding from my mouth, bleeding from my rectum. In 15 shots, the chemotherapy was quite powerful. Then I asked my doctor to please reduce the dose. It was nice of him, Dr. Agarwal, very nice. Then instead of three in a week, I had to take one. And gradually, in the span of say about 25-30, I lost a lot of weight. And from 70 kgs, I came to 30-35 kgs. Then Dr. Agarwal said, you'll have to eat this, but very difficult to eat also. Because of these chemotherapy drugs, all these allopathic drugs have 100% side effects. Then I visited my niece's daughter in Godrej Colony. She was a G6PD patient, and she lost all her hair because of some miscalculation of the drug by the doctor. When I seen her, it was just pathetic. 8-year-old child, no hair on her head, no hair, and she was just hospitalized in the ICU. After a month, I seen her again, and she was totally different. Nice hair, everything back. Then I asked her, how you got this? There is weak. She said, no. Then she told me, an 8-year-old child, that wheat grass, which Godrej grow in their campus, the doctor gave her wheat grass, and she started taking wheat grass. And by taking wheat grass, she got her hair back. Everything was fine. So I started taking wheat grass from there. It was this 8-year-old child who told me, and I took it. I said, no, I'll also. She told Mama, you'll also become fine. So from that time onwards, I started taking wheatgrass, and slowly, slowly, this blue vanished. Then slowly, slowly, my hair started coming, and then I could get my bearings onto the chemo properly. So I took 142 shots. After 142 shots, and with wheatgrass continuing, then in the year 2006, an article came out from the Indian Science Institute for paan, plain paan. If you eat paan, it is good for cancer, good for diabetes, good for... So I started eating paan also. Then I started eating a lot of greens, radish, no red meat, no liquor, nothing. I'm by name Daruwalla, but I don't drink, no smoking, nothing. So, you know, I had cuddled everything. Staunch, pure vegetarian, like, and more of healthy food. I used to boil my food. And in this trouble, in this sickness of mine, I have not given one apposite trouble to my wife, my son, my daughter, anybody. I used to go to my doctor, come alone, take the shot with my grandson in my hand, and fight it out. Those 2.5 years was very bad. In the sense, really very bad. Afterwards, in 2002 December, Dr. Agarwal told, I told him, now that's enough, abhi WBC bhi kaafi kam ho gaya. I had, when I was diagnosed, it was 1,25,500. So I brought it down to 15,000. He said, still it is high. I said, forget it. I'll taking wheatgrass, it will come down and all that. He said, no, no. Then he said, wait. Then he made me write, fill up an form. And then I filled up the form. And by grace of God, because of doctor, because of Novartis, because of Max Foundation, I have received one medicine called Glivex. It is only for chronic myeloid leukemia, in the first stage of cancer, blood cancer. So I got this medicine. Each tablet was 1,000 rupees, beyond my reach. So I got it free of cost, first from US. It was okayed by my doctor. Till today, I have received 55 lakhs worth medicine free of cost through my doctor, through Max Foundation, through Novartis. And I, in one way, I thank God he gave me cancer. So by getting cancer, I did a lot of reading. Lot. From A to Z, I read a lot about cancer. And then I took on to wheatgrass. I took on to pan. Then I took on to yogurt. Doctor said, you take yogurt, it will be cooling and it will be nice. It will give you bacteria to fight cancer cells. So I did that. And whatever, my doctor said, I interacted. Then some of my friends said, abhi homeopathy lalo, you will get some relief, etc. Okay. If I don't listen to my friends, they'll get angry. So I did homeopathy. But that was a boomerang. I took 28 shots in my stomach, Iskada injections, very costly and very painful. But then I told doctor, that homeopath doctor, please don't stop this medicine. He said, I'm your doctor, you're my doctor. I said, I'm your patient, but don't stop this allopathy medicine. Let it be, and you give me your homeopathy, I'll take. I spent 3-4 lakhs for that also, but results were zero. When it spoiled my case. Then I caught my yes. I said, no, I'm fine with my doctor. And it was that time I was taking 400 dose. Today I'm taking 600 dose oral chemotherapy. And apart from all this, wheatgrass I still continue to take. I take beetroot. I take a lot of salad. I eat like a goat. More of salad, greens. And I do a lot of social work. Lot of social work in the sense to keep myself occupied. And when I started taking wheatgrass, I got the know-how from US. First from Godrej, and they told me how to grow, etc. But just simply growing and taking doesn't matter. Then I got the entire write-up from US, Dr. Annie Wigmose. Then I put it on my computer. Then it was difficult for me to every time print and give to everybody. Then I told, okay, I asked my friend, my son and daughter, they helped me out and printed a lot of books. I started giving everybody one wheatgrass book. I'll show you. Then with that, from where you get wheatgrass, from where you get the wheatgrass tablet, from everything, all information. So that when I give a book to somebody of a wheatgrass, he or she should read and get herself, himself okay. Then I said, now the poor cancer patients, I interact a lot with the poor cancer patient because, and I keep away from the doctor because I'm fine. Well, now I don't have 1% of cancer, etc. I go for my periodical checkup, but I do a lot of social work. Help the poor cancer patients, get them to my house, see that I make the applications, guide them to the right institutions where they get help. Then I make, that is, quilts out of rags. Out of that I make pillows. I have distributed 250 so far to the cancer patients. I'll show you, I brought everything. To the cancer patient. Very good question. I have asked this question to my doctor. What happened? Not drinking, not smoking, etc. It was about worry. I was having some family problem, some stress, court case, etc. That was a major, because I was a swimming coach. I had no bad habits, no smoking, no drinking, nothing. And then because of this court, lawyer, and then fighting the case and fighting it for my daughter and son, you know, this put me off. I won the case, etc. But with the result, I was losing. I lost weight from 70 kgs to 30 kgs. And I was, my pants became loose. So when I went for my checkup, that time I came to know that I'm a leukemia patient. And leukemia ABCD, I didn't know. But only after doctor explained to me and then started reading, I interacted a lot with my doctor, attended a lot of seminars, etc. And then got the grip of cancer. And today I am helping lots of cancer patients. I asked him this question. He said, it's a very difficult question to answer, you, whether you this or that, but Dr. Agarwal couldn't give, he gave me some books, how to, on what, how to, what are the ways of, but then, you know, what I read, every human being has cancer cells in his her body, everybody has. So, it is only time when it erupts, and when it erupts like a volcano. In my case, it erupted, I didn't know also. But when I lost in 2 months' time 40 kgs, then it was too far off. My blood count, my WBC was 1,25,800, which was very, very high. And doctor said, you didn't fall. I said, no, I said, I'm driving my scooter and I'm failure. Yes, but there are 6 stages of leukemia. I'm in the ground floor, the chronic myeloid leukemia, the first stage of leukemia. After that, there's acute myeloid leukemia. After that, there's lymphoma leukemia. So many stages. I am still in the ground floor. If little bit of ABCD, this side, that side, I must have kicked the bucket long time back. But taking care of my health, keeping myself occupied, doing a lot of social work, and I interact more with the poor cancer patient. Poor means really poor. Fisherwoman, breadwala. I keep myself away from the educated and the rich people, because if we explain to them, they have first, and sorry to tell, our so-called educated people, when we say, they have a negative approach in life. I believe in having positive. Today, because of the help of Dr. Darais, who is a good homeopath, through him, we have been helping a lot of cancer patients who are in the last stage, where Tatas, Prince Ali Khan, Boman, Agarwal have lifted their hands up, Advani said, anyway, today, for the last 15 days, I'm fighting with a girl who's only 26 years old, having a 4-year-old child. She's having Hodgkin's lymphoma. It's a reverse type. And she's on bed. But believe me, in these 15 days, we could bring her out from the tiger's mouth. 40% we achieved. We achieved in the sense by giving her pan, by giving her wheatgrass, by giving her